Yesterday we have derived this equation for stresses for Dietz conduits, and it is not possible for Dietz conduits vertically cut. Generally the side slope has been provided in case of Dietz conduit. So, this is your distance B D, and we have derived this. If this is my B C, B C is your diameter of the conduit, B D is your width of your ditch. We have derived this W C is equal to yesterday C D gamma B D square, where C D is equal to, C D is called load coefficient, C D is called load coefficient for Dietz conduits, load coefficient for Dietz conduits. Now, the value of C D is equal to, we derived it 1 minus e to the power minus 2 k mu prime capital H by B D, and divided by 2 k mu prime. So, it has been this coefficient of load coefficient for Dietz conduits has been given graphically for Dietz conduits. If I plot between this H by B D versus is your load coefficient C D, start with this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. Now, it starts with 1 up to 14. So, the range is coming about between this, if you look at here, this has been given graphically. Now, this value of, if I take it k mu prime value of 0.12, and this value is equal to k mu prime is equal to 0.11, and this range is for clay, for clay, and this is if I am taking k mu is equal to k mu prime is equal to 1.112, this is your k mu prime is equal to 1.94. So, this range is particularly for sand or cohesionless soil. This is your dimensionless parameter. If I take it H by B D, this is a dimensionless parameter, and C D is equal to load coefficient. If you note the load coefficient, because this load coefficient has been derived for different value of H by B D, different value of K and mu prime. K is your lateral earth pressure coefficient, mu prime is your friction between your ditch and your side fill soil, and if you know this k mu h and b d, you can find it out this c d value. So, it has been plotted for different soils. It has been taken for two kinds of soil, one is your cohesionless soil, that is sand, other is for clay. The range is well defined. For clay, it is varying between k mu prime 0.112, k mu prime is equal to 0.12. within this band of this range, this is for clay soils, and this for sand, k mu prime is equal to 1.11 and k mu prime is equal to 0.11 to 0.194. I did a mistake. 0.11 to 0.194. So the range is well defined. You can say that for particularly 0.11 to 0.194, you can say that this is for sand. 0.11 to 0.120, we can say that this is for range for clay. In case of this derivation is basically for rigid ditch. So in case of flexible pipes, conduits, so what will happen in case of flexible piles? Some degree of stiffness should be applied. For flexible pipes, some degree of stiffness at the pipe itself value, we can say that degree of stiffness WC, which is equal to BC by BD, the load on flexible pile would then be, then it will be, this is your degree of stiffness. So WC is equal to CD gamma BD square into BC by BD. So this comes out to be CD gamma BD and BC. Gamma BD and BC. If you look at this, if this pipe, sometimes what happened? Actually, in practice, not a single pipe or maybe all pipes are not perfectly rigid. There will be some flexibility. So this flexibility degree of stiffness has been added. With this, the modified value of load is coming, how much to the vertical, means particularly above the ditch. This is your CD, that means load coefficient, into gamma BD into BC. BD is your width of your ditch, BC is your diameter of width of your ditch, and BC is your diameter of your conduit. So in this case, this is for rigid conduits and this is for your flexible pipes or flexible conduits. Now we will move forward for the other classification. One part is over. As I said earlier, there are three types of, basically we use these conduits. One is your ditch conduits, other is your positive projecting conduits, third is your negative projecting conduits. Let us start with the second one. This is your positive projecting conduits. Positive projecting conduits means it will be raised. If you look at here, it will rest. For example, why it is called positive projecting conduits? If you look at here, it just slightly embedded below the ground surface, and it will, this pipe or the conduits, it will above the ground surface, above the ground surface. That's why it is projecting, this some part is projecting above the ground surface. That's why it is called positive projecting conduits. Now where it has been used? As I said earlier, it has been used for culverts for highway. Culverts for highway, then railway or airfield. If you look at here, if there is a ground surface here, if this is your positive projecting conduits, what will happen? Generally, this has been allowed passage of water. So what happened? The road has been constructed above this, but actually this conduit is lying above the ground surface. Your ground surface is here. So it has been practically used, particularly culverts or railways, culverts for highways, culverts for railways, it has been practically applied. So now if I am considering this positive projecting conduits, so there is a differential settlement between the central zone directly overlying the conduit and the side zone. Let me draw two figures. So, this is your top of embankment. This is your top of embankment and this is your ground surface. This is your ground surface or ground level. Now, what will happen if I, let me draw it completely. So, in this case, this is your shearing stress. Shearing stress, this is your central zone, this called central zone. More settlement, and this I can term as a flexible conduits. Now, same thing I draw for rigid conduits. Now, in case of rigid conduits, if you look out the graph, this is your shearing stress, this is your shearing stress. This part is your central zone. Less settlement. Now, I can say that this is your rigid conduits. There are two differences. If I am taking this positive projecting conduits, I can separate out this what is your shearing stress and central zone. These are the two conduits, so positive conduits. Here it is your ground level or ground surface. If it is a flexible, what will happen? The central zone, there are two zones. One is your central zone at the middle part, other part is your side or shearing stress zone. What will happen? The central zone will settle more than your side shearing stress developed. So, what will happen? The shearing stresses will be vertically upward in case of flexible conduit. What is the reason that in flexible conduit central zone will settle more? Because it is lying above your conduits, because it is a flexible conduit, it will also settle. So, the central zone will settle more as compared to your side. So, shearing stresses will be acting upward. In case of rigid conduits, if you look at here, it is perfectly rigid. Though the settlement of the rigid conduit as compared to flexible conduits will be less. So, the shearing stresses will be vertically downward and the side friction means side settlement will be more as compared to your central zone. Central zone will be your less settlement. This is the difference between flexible conduits and your rigid conduits, particularly positive projecting conduits. Now, if I start with this, detail how this settlement occur as compared to top and bottom. Let me draw another two figures. critical plane has to be shown, this critical plane where it is lying. The direction of shearing stress can be determined from the settlement of a plane, means particularly the direction of the shearing stress can be determined from the settlement of a plane, that is called critical plane. So, let me draw it. Now, this is my, say, you can say that this is your ground surface. As compared to this, so this distance, this is your completely, let me write it, this is P BC, BC is your diameter of your conduits, and this is your, this part will be delta G. And now, how the conduits will behave? This conduits will go now this part to this part is your delta F, and this complete part will be your delta F plus DC. DC is your width of your, means DC is your width of your, means vertical deflection of your conduits DC. Then this is called, this is called critical plane after settlement. Now, if I take this side shearing stresses as compared to your vertical, means central zone. Now, one more figure. This is particularly in case of, what is the mechanics, what is the mechanism I am showing. This is in case of flexible conduits, this is in case of your rigid conduits. Now, this is my critical plane after settlement. And this will be delta M plus delta G, and this becomes your delta F plus DC. Now, this is your delta F. Now, this is your original ground surface. Now, this is your delta G. Now, I can write it out, a ratio known as settlement ratio, a ratio known as settlement ratio with respect to these two figures. I am coming back, let me finish it. A ratio called settlement ratio, this is called RP, RP, this is not gamma, this is a RP called settlement ratio. Which is equal to delta m plus delta g minus delta f plus dc by delta m. So, delta m is your, let me define it, delta m is equal to compression of the field, compression of the field on the sides of the conduits in the distance PBC. So, delta m is equal to compression of the field on the sides of the conduits in the distance PBC, delta g is equal to settlement of natural ground surface, settlement of natural ground surface adjacent to the conduits, adjacent to the conduits, delta f is equal to settlement of conduit into the foundation, settlement of conduit into foundation, and DC, DC is equal to vertical deflection of conduits, DC is equal to vertical deflection of conduits. So, if you look at this, P is equal to projection ratio, P is equal to projection ratio, BC is equal to diameter or width of the conduits. If you look at here, now there are, in case of positive projecting conduits, there are two phenomena. One is your flexible conduits, other is your rigid conduits. Let us start with one by one. This is your flexible conduits. In case of flexible conduits, what will happen? As the conduit is flexible, what will happen? It will settle. That means the soil above the conduits, that we called as a central zone, and soil side by this conduit, this is called side zone. The central zone will be shear more as compared to your side zone. That is why what will happen? The shearing stress will be vertically upward. Now, if I look at this, if I look at this, look at, there is called critical plane. It cannot settle up to a certain depth. It will settle up to the critical plane after the settlement. So, what will happen? If you look at here, delta f plus dc, what is dc? Dc is your vertical deflection of conduits. Dc is your how much vertical deflection of your conduits, and delta f is your settlement of conduit into the foundation, settlement of the conduit into foundation. Vertical deflection of conduits, if you look at here, DC is your vertical deflection of your conduit, delta F is your settlement of conduit into the foundation. That means, once there is a flexible conduit, what will happen? The conduit itself deflects, this is called DC. Also, the conduit also goes inside your foundation. That means, it will also penetrate inside your foundation. So, this is your critical plane. P is your projection ratio. What do you mean by projection ratio? How much it is projected above your ground level or ground surface? How much it is projected? If this is my conduits, from this, how much it is projected above your ground surface? If this is my ground level, how much it is projected above your ground surface? As compared, if this is my D or DC or BC, whatever you say, if it is the diameter, with this respect to diameter, how much it is projected above. So, with respect to PBC, the deflection at the top will be, total deflection at the top will be delta F plus DC, because it is a flexible conduit. Now, If I write it in terms of settlement ratio, in terms of settlement ratio, it will be delta m plus delta g minus delta f plus dc by delta m. What is your delta m? Compression of field on the sides of the conduits in the distance PBC. Compression of the field delta m, compression of your field on the sides. If I look at this, this is your, this value is your, this is your delta g, and this value is your, this complete value is your delta m plus delta g, delta m plus delta g. Delta m is your compression of field on the sides of the conduits in the distance PBC, on the sides of the conduits. How much? Soil sample, both the sides of the conduits, it will compress, it will settle. And delta g is your settlement of natural ground surface adjacent to the conduits. Settlement of natural ground surface, if this is my natural ground surface, how much it settle, delta g adjacent to your conduits, how much it settle. Now, this with respect to the settlement ratio, we can find it out what is your settlement of your central zone of your flexible as well as rigid conduits. Now, you come back to rigid conduits. In case of rigid conduit, what will happen? You see, this is your delta f plus delta dc. The delta f, what is your delta f? Settlement of conduit into the foundation, vertical deflection of conduits. This part will be less as compared to your flexible, as compared to your flexible. In case of flexible, delta f plus dc will be more than your delta f plus dc in case of rigid. That is why what will happen, central part of the soil above these conduits will settle more. Once it will settle more, whole mass will be settling as compared to your side soil. That is why this shearing stress will be vertically up. In this case, what will happen? The central part will be settle less as compared to your side soil. What will happen? Your shear stress will be vertically downward. This is the physics behind it. So, these are all, this P is equal to projection ratio, BC is your diameter of these conduits. Now, with respect to the settlement ratio, with respect to the settlement ratio, then if I say settlement ratio is negative, the moment I say that settlement ratio is negative, that means conduits settle more than your critical plane. Settlement ratio, when it will be possible to be negative? Delta m plus delta g. Delta m plus delta g is your settlement of adjacent soil compared to your conduits. If you come back to delta f plus dc, this is your settlement of your, this is your settlement of your conduits. Now, if I, the moment I say settlement ratio is negative, that means this value is more than this value. So, what will happen? Settlement ratio of, if it is a negative, conduit will settle more than yours, more than your critical plane. These conduits, particularly this conduit, will settle more than your critical plane. This exactly happened in case of delta f plus dc will be more than delta m plus delta g in case of flexible conduits, but in case of rigid conduits, it will be more than this case. So, accordingly that this physics will change. So, settlement ratio of various settlement ratio for different conduits, the value has been given. Some values, I am just writing the some few of these values. Based on your settlement ratio, we can decide whether it is a flexible conduits or rigid conduits. So, now the values of the settlement ratio has been given. Conduit condition, and this is your settlement ratio. Now, rigid conduits on a foundation rock, just few cases, you can get it chart from, there are different charts, means different values also there. I am just enumerating few cases. First one is your rigid conduits. Rigid conduits on foundation of rock, this value will be exactly plus 1. This value will be exactly settlement ratio is equal to plus 1, because it is rigid conduits, again it is on the surface of the rock. Rock mass means the settlement of ground surface will be less as far as possible, and the settlement of rigid means conduit also it will settle less, means it is very negligible. That is why the settlement ratio will be your plus 1. Now, second part is your rigid conduit on foundation of ordinary soil. Ordinary soil means any soil, it is varying from plus 0.5 to plus 0.8. Why it is plus, why it is not negative? Why it is plus? Because this is a rigid conduit. The settlement ratio, if I write it, the settlement ratio is equal to, once again for your reference, Rp is equal to delta m plus delta g minus delta f plus dc by delta m. If you look at, it is positive because this term, settlement of the side of the soil will be more than compared to your settlement of your conduits, that is why it is plus, and this range is plus 5 to 0.5 to 0.8. Second part is your flexible conduits with poorly compacted side soil, with poorly compacted side soil, this comes out to be minus 0.40 to 1.0. Then fourth part is your just this flexible, it is a flexible conduits plus well compacted, well compacted soil, this comes out to be minus 0.20 to sometimes plus 0.80. If it is, sorry, 0.42, it will be 0.0. If you look at this particularly flexible conduits, if the soil has not been compacted properly, it will be always in the minus side. It will be always in the minus side because deflection because of your conduits, deflection because of your soil below the foundation, conduits below the foundation will be more as compared to this. Now, for if it is a well compacted soil, generally it is varying from minus 0.2 to plus 0.8. These are all your typical range. I will stop it here. Next class, I will start about your negative projecting conduits. Thanks a lot. Thank you.